Thank you, Mr. President. I seek leave to make a brief explanation before addressing a question without notice to the Attorney-General on the issue of raising the age of criminal responsibility. Last week, my office has received a substantial number of emails, as I believe have other members of this place, calling for the age of criminal responsibility to be raised to 14. Just last week, the Tasmanian Government committed to raising the age to 14 in line with the recommendations from the United Nations. This follows the ACT, where a similar commitment has been made. The Council of Attorney Generals last year postponed the decision to raise the age. Meanwhile, children between the ages of 10 and 14 continue to be sent to detention. When asked about this issue last month, the Attorney General told this House that raising the age is an important issue. He also informed us, and I quote, that on occasions the entire population of the Youth Detention Centre in South Australia is made up of Aboriginal people. Given the Attorney General sees this as such an important issue, my question to him is, how many children does the Malinauskas government intend to allow to end up in detention before it follows the lead of other states and territories and raises the age of criminal responsibility to 14?
Answer the Attorney General. Sorry, Mr. Sims, you asked for leave to make a brief explanation. I think I must have missed that. So, is leave granted? In retrospect, leave is granted. The Attorney General.
I thank the honourable member for his question. It is an important one, and I note his strong interest in this area. I think since the honourable member last asked that question, there have been a number of discussions that have taken place, and certainly over the winter break, I will be discussing with colleagues. Initially in the ACT, but following the announcement the honourable member referred to that I think Tasmania made last week about their intentions, we'll also seek advice about what they're doing, because it is not just a case of changing a bit of legislation to say instead of 10 substitute the number 14. It's also about what alternatives there are, what services might be provided to young people who find themselves in contact with the justice system. But also too, I know that jurisdictions that are starting to go down this path are looking at are there any things that will stay included and carve out. So it is an important question. There will be further discussions over the winter break that we'll be having with other jurisdictions. But there, we certainly continue, both myself and officers from my office and my department, discussions with different groups around Australia about this issue.